American singer-songwriter and pianist Tori Amos is truly one of a kind. The classically trained musician writes from the soul and is now sharing her latest musings in the form of a post-lockdown studio album called Ocean to Ocean. I had the pleasure of catching up with the creative genius herself to hear all about her latest music masterpiece. It is such a pleasure to talk to you. Thanks so much for your time. I've just been listening to a couple of tracks from Ocean to Ocean and I'm in a good place. I'm thinking of trees and I'm thinking of the one thing we could do in this lockdown, getting out into nature, which is what we did to keep sane. So I really got into this album. What inspired you?
If you were feeling low, I just became like a mother grizzly bear and hibernated. But once I could get myself out of that chair and get out, side, then I was able to begin to see that Mother Nature wasn't in lockdown. No. She was rebirthing, she was regenerating, she was busy. And that's what I got inspired by.
You were a child prodigy, accepted into a prestigious music school when you were just 5 years old. Has that been a gift for you throughout your life? Or has it ever been a bit of a curse?
Yes. My dad, bless him, he's 93, he's about to be 94. He would say to me sometimes, you know, if only I had your gift, what I would have done with it. He didn't value his amazing gift of preaching. He's a great preacher, but I think he always wanted to do something else. But sometimes we don't value the gifts we're given. And I think that might be true for me too.
Never was a cornflake girl. Thought that was a good solution, hanging with the raisin girl.
You mentioned your father was a preacher or a minister, and is it true that he and your mum were so inspired by your gift and were so keen for you to succeed that they actually took you to play in gay bars when you were young?
Yeah, my dad went to the gay bars and the gays thought that he was dressing up in a costume.
Wow.
So that was a bit of a wake-up call for the gays, realizing in no costume, that's really a preacher with a Bible sitting there chaperoning his teenage daughter. And he got a lot of flack from the parishioners over that. But he responded, and this is where he's great. He said, where else is a 13-year-old girl safer than in a gay bar? That's absolutely true.
If the peel out the watch would just peel out the watchword.
Cornflake Girl, of course, was one of your huge hits, but you were actually in a cereal ad.
It was a Just Right commercial, and it looked like cornflakes, and they made me cut my hair to appeal to a certain demographic because it was a bit wild.
And a gun and a man on my back.
Not long after that, you released an incredibly powerful song called Me and a Gun, which you said you wrote after seeing Thelma and Louise because it brought up a very traumatic time in your life.
Songs come when they're ready to be birthed, when they are ready, and when they think I'm ready to carry them.
These things go through your head. When there's a man on your back.
You started the National Rape and Incest Hotline, becoming a spokesperson for people who couldn't or hadn't found the courage to speak up themselves. Were you ready for everything that followed?
In some ways, Angela, I was ready, but in other ways, what I was not ready for was the response to it and the attention, and then that became a shock because I wasn't ready to talk about it. And so instead of it staying in an art form, then it started to become a discussion, which then started to magnify feeling like your skin was off. So I had to work through that.
With the lights on, it's less dangerous. Here we are.
You've also also done some covers over the years, mostly at live concerts, which have gone ballistic. For instance, Nirvana's Smells Like Teen Spirit and Depeche Mode and a couple of others. What does it have to be about a song that someone else has written that makes you want to grab it and put your stamp on it?
There's some kind of synergy. I take it to the piano or I take it to the keyboards, and it just seems to find the song within the song. And when a song is really well written like that, it can hold different arrangements.
You have a very special relationship with your fans here in Australia. They pretty much go off like a frog in a sock when you're here. I know you've got some tour plans set for early next year elsewhere. How are we looking?
I'd love to come. Frogs in the sock. And I'd love to come down. I love it down there. Any time of year. I'll come in the winter. I'll come anytime.
The brand new album from Tori Amos, Ocean to Ocean, is out right now and it is beautiful. So make sure you take a listen. And remember, if any issues have been raised for you in this story and you need help, Lifeline is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week on 13 11 14.